A very good morning to my dear children. Welcome back to Maths Online class. Dear children, in the previous class, we discussed about Indian system and international system. Today, we will go to discuss one more new topic, that is large numbers used in our daily life situations and exercise 1.5. Before going to the class, how to use large numbers used in our daily life situations. The unit of length is meter. The unit of weight is kilogram. The unit of volume is liter. The unit of time is seconds. Some more short measurements let us discuss. Okay? 10 millimeters equal to 1 centimeter. 100 centimeters equal to 1 meter, 1000 meters equal to 1 kilometer, 1000 liters equal to 1 kiloliter, 1000 grams equal to 1 kg. We use these measures in our daily life situations every day. First one, exercise 1.5. The number of people who visited during Commonwealth Games in New Delhi for the first 4 days was recorded as in Commonwealth Games is New Delhi first 4 days record. First day how many members recorded? 15,290. Second day how many members were recorded? 14,181. Third day, how many members were recorded? Third day is 14,235. Fourth day, 10,578. They are asking how many numbers attended New Delhi Commonwealth Games. They are asking total. So, we have to add all these numbers. When we arrange these numbers, place value wise, you have to write nana. Ones place order, you have to write in ones order. Tens place value, hundreds, thousands, 10,000. Write in one order. Ones place onwards, we have to add. This side, right side. 8 plus 5, 13. 13 plus 1, 14. So write here 1, write down 4, next 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 8, 18, 8 plus 1, 19, 19 plus 9, 28, write 2 here and write down 8, okay, write down 8, next 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 2, 12. Write here 1, write here 2, okay, 2. Next, thousands place, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 4, 14. So, write here 1, write down 4. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5. So, 4 days record is total number of people who are attended in a Commonwealth Games 54,284 persons attended in Commonwealth Game. So 54,284 people visited Commonwealth Games in these 4 days. First, you have to write steps nana, then write in order, you have to add. Here they are asking total, that's why you have to choose here addition. Add this. How many members are attended in Commonwealth Games? 54,284. Second one. In Lok Sabha election, the elected candidates got 5,87,500 votes and defeated candidate got 3,52,768 votes. By how many votes did the winner win the election?
how many votes did the winner win the election?
Number of votes the winner got. Here, 587,500 votes winner got. Number of votes the defeated candidate. How many votes get defeated candidates? Who are loser the election? He is only defeated candidate. 352,768 votes got. Now we have to find out how many more votes elect the winner. How do we find this? When we subtract elected candidates' votes minus defeated candidates' votes. Now we have to get how many more votes answer. That is the difference. 587,500 minus 352,768. Here, subtract. Zero is the smaller number, not possible to subtract. So, what we do? We have to take borrow to before number. 0 become 10, 0 become 9, 5 become 4. Okay? 10 minus 8. Equal to 2, 9 minus 6 equal to 3, 4 minus 7, is it possible? No. So, take borrow to before number, 4 become 14, 7 become 6, 14 minus 7 equal to 7, 6 minus 2 equal to 4, 8 minus 5 equal to 3, 5 minus 3 equal to 2. How many more votes get the winner? By the defeated candidate, 234,732 more votes by the elected candidates. Therefore, 234,732 votes more votes get the elected. I will explain. In Lok Sabha election, elected candidates got how many votes? Elected candidates got 587,500 votes. In defeated candidates got 352,768. They are asking how many votes did the winner win the election? Here winner 587,500 votes. No. What is the difference between in these two? Now, how we find out this? When we subtracted elected own candidates' votes minus defeated candidates' votes, when we subtract these two, we have to how many votes more than elected winner got? Now, okay, 587,500 minus 352,768. When we subtract these two, we have to get how many more votes? Elected candidate got 234,732 more votes. Okay, this is the solution of the second problem. Now go to third problem. Write the greatest and smallest 5-digit number formed by the digits 5, 3, 4, 0 and 7 and their difference. Here, digits are 5, 3, 4, 0, 7. Using these digits, formed 5-digit greatest number and 5-digit smallest number. Now then find out their difference. What our solution is? What are given digits 5, 3, 4, 0, 7? Using these digits, now find out greatest number. Here, which one is greater number? 7. Next, 5. Next, 4, 3, 0. Greatest number to smallest number. Because here we find greatest number. Given digit greatest number is 75,430. Now, use this digits, find out the smallest number. Don't write 0 in first. When we write 0 in first, that is 4-digit number. For example, write 0, 3, 4, 5, 7. Not there in 0. Here 4 only, 4 digit only, no? This is wrong, Nana. Don't write like this. You have to write faster. 0 after number, what is there? 3. Now you have to take 3, then go to take 0. After 0, 3, 0, 4, 5, 7. This is the smallest number, smallest 5-digit number for the given numbers. Now they are asking difference. No, difference means subtract. Which is the greatest number and which is the smallest number? Now find out the difference. So 75,430 minus 30,457. Okay, now subtract. 3 0 is the smaller number than the 7. So what we do? Take borrow 2. Before number 0 become 10. 3 become 2. 3 become 2. 10 minus 7 equal to 3. 2 is also smaller number. So what we do? Here we have to take one more borrowing. 4 become 3. 12 minus 5 equal to 7. 3 also smaller than the 4. So again we have to take borrow. 3 become 13. 5 become 4. Is it clear everybody? 13 minus 14 minus 4 equal to 9. 13 minus 4 equal to 9. 4 minus 0. 5 also smaller. Now again we have to take borrow. 5 become 4. 4 minus 0. 4. Next 7 minus 3. 4. Dear children, when you arrange these numbers, write in order. Nana, ones place order, tens place order, hundreds place order, like that you have to order correctly. Then you have to get correct answer. Okay, the difference. What is the difference in these two numbers? 44,973. 447 difference is, therefore, the difference is 44,973. Okay, this leg we have to find out difference. Remember this. Fourth one, a bicycle industry makes 3,125 bicycles each day. A bicycle industry makes how many bicycles each day? 3,125 bicycles each day. Find the total number of bicycles manufactured for the month of July. In the month of July, how many bicycles manufactured in cycle industry? Okay, for day, how many cycles manufactured? 3,125. They are asking, find out the how many cycles manufactured month of July. How many days are there in month of July? 30 or 31? 31 days, no? Solution. Number of days in the month of July. How many days are there in the month of July? 31 days. So right here, 31. Number of bicycles made one day. How many bicycles made manufactured in the cycle industry? 3,125. So they are asking month of July how many bicycles, no? So multiply 3,135 into 31. 3,125 into 31. Okay, now when we multiplied any number by 1, that number only we have to get, no? 1 5 is 5, 1 2 is 2, 1 1 is 1, 1 3 is 3. Leave this digit, 1's digit. Again you have to multiply by 3. 3 5 is 15. Right here, 5, 3 2s are 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9. Now add these two products. 5, 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 1, 8, 3 plus 3, 6, 9. In the month of July, bicycle industry makes manufactured the cycles are 96,875 in the month of July. Therefore, number of cycles made in July, 96,875,000 bicycles made in July. made in July. Okay, once again I will explain. A bicycle industry makes 3125 bicycles per day, one day. So how many bicycles manufactured in the month of July? In the month of July, how many days are there? 31. So 31 into one day manufacture. One day manufacture is 3125 bicycles. So 3125 into 31 is equal to 96,875 bicycles manufactured in the month of July. One, a helicopter covers 600 kilometers in 1 hour. How much distance will it cover in 4 hours? A helicopter covers 600 kilometers in 1 hour. So they are asking 4 hours. How many distance will it cover? Here asking, express your answer in meters. Here kilometers given, no? Now convert into meters after completion of this. Distance covered by helicopter in 1 hour. A helicopter covers 600 kilometers in 1 hour. 1 hour, how many kilometers covers? 600 kilometers. Okay? 600 kilometers. 600 kilometers. 1 hour equal to 600 kilometers. Distance covered in 4 hours. 1 hour, 600 kilometers. 4 hours equal to 600 into 4. 600 into 4. Okay? Kilometers. 600 into 4. Distance covered by helicopter in 1 hour, 600 kilometers. Distance covered in 4 hours. 1 hour, 600 kilometers. 4 hours means 600 kilometers into 4. Okay? Into 4. 6 4s are 24. Remaining 2 zeros. But they are asking, express your answer in meters, no? So this is kilometer. 1 kilometer, how many meters? 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. Therefore, 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. We know that already discussed. Okay, distance. Helicopter covers the distance. Covered the distance in 4 hours. 4 hours is 2400 kilometer, but this answer expressed in meters. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters, no? So which is the place kilometer? We have to substitute 1000 meters. 2400 into 1000 meters. Here we have to convert kilometer into meter. 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. Now multiply it. 24 ones are 24. Here 2 zeros. Here 3 zeros. Total how many zeros? 5 zeros. So helicopter covered the distance in 4 hours. 24 lakh meters. Once again. Distance covered by helicopter in 1 hour. In 1 hour, 600 kilometers covered the distance. Okay? Distance in how many kilometers covered in 4 hours? So, 1 hour distance into 4. Okay? 6, 4, 24, 2 zeros. But here asking, express your answer in meters. That's why kilometers convert into meters. 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. Multiplied by 1000, we have to get answer is 24 lakh meters.
Look here children.
Sixth one, the total weight of a box of 5 biscuit packets same size is 8 kgs 400 grams. Okay, total weight of box of 5 biscuit packets same size is 8 kgs 400 grams. What is the weight of each packet? Here Equal weight, 5 biscuit packets are equal weight, same size. What is that? 8 kgs, 400 grams. They are asking the weight of each packet. The total weight of 5 biscuit packets, 8 kgs, 400 grams. They are asking the weight of each packet. Look here children, two measurements given here, kgs, grams. So, convert this also into grams. 1 kg equal to 1000 grams. So, which is the place of kilograms? We have to substitute grams because both measurements in same value, same. So, 8 kg, 400 grams equal to 8 into 1000 grams plus 400 grams. Okay, 400 grams. 8 into 1000, 8000 grams plus 400 grams. 8400 grams. Total is 8400 grams. They are asking this is the weight of 5 biscuits packets. So, one biscuit packet weight is 8400 by 5, because this is the 5 biscuit packets weight. No, that's right. 8400 grams divided by 5. Now divide. Direct cancellation also possible, Anna. 5 ones are 5. First 5 ones are 5, remaining 3 there, no, 34. 5 6 are 34. 5 8 are 40, remaining 0. Okay, look here once again. 8400 divided by 5 now. 5 ones are 5 3 4. 5 6 are 30 minus 4. 5 8 are 40, remaining 0. So, this is the answer, Nana. What is that one biscuit packet? One biscuit packet weight is 1680 grams or 1680 grams. Okay, 1680 grams or 1 kg 680 grams also correct. Okay, then the cost of petrol is 60 rupees per liter. A petrol bunk sells 750 liters petrol on a day. How much money do they get at end of the day? 1 liter petrol cost is 60 rupees. Cost of 750 liters petrol. So, 1 liter petrol cost is 60 rupees. How to find out 750 liters petrol cost? When we multiply it by 1 liter petrol cost, we have to get 750 liters petrol into 60 rupees. This is the cost of 1 liter now. This is the cost of 750. Now, 75 into 6. Okay? 6 5 jar 30. 6 7 jar 6 5 jar 30. 6 7 jar 42. 42 plus 3. 45, remaining 2 zeros, right aside. So, bank at the end of the day, 45,000 rupees per day. Therefore, they get money at the end of the day, 45,000 rupees. Look here children, 1 liter petrol cost is 60 rupees. This sells every day 750 liters. So, what is the cost of 750 liters petrol? 1 liter petrol cost is 60 rupees. So, 750 into 60. When we find out 750 liters petrol, we have to multiply it by 60. So, when we multiply these two, we have to get the product is 45,000. The 750 liters petrol cost is 45,000 rupees. Okay, they get money in one day, 45,000 rupees. Now let us discuss try these problems. Try this. Name 4 important towns in your district. Note the distance between them in kilometers. Express these
in centimeters and millimeters. Look here, children. Name any four towns in your district. Note the distance between. For example, Khammam to Kothagudem. What is the distance in that Khammam to Kothagudem? Convert into centimeters and millimeters. Okay. Can you tell where we use milligrams? Where we use milligrams? Gold, silver. That like no? Third one. A box contains 1 lakh tablets, each weighing 20 milligrams. What is the weight of all the tablets in the box in both grams and kilograms? A box contains each weighing 20 milligrams. What is the weight of all the tablets in the box of both grams and kilograms? Third one, fourth one, I will explain, Nana. Try these. First one, second one, do your own in your homework notebook. Okay, third one.
Try these. A box contains 1 lakh tablets, each weighing 20 milligrams. What is the weight of all the tablets in the box in both grams and kilograms? The weight of one tablet, first two is in your homework book, Nana, write in your homework book. Third one, solution. The weight of one tablet is 20 milligrams. The weight of one tablet is 20 milligrams. The total weight of 1 lakh tablets. One tablet weight is 20 milligrams. So, total weight of, look here children, weight of one tablet 20 milligrams. Total weight of 1 lakh tablets. So, one tablet weight is 20 milligrams. The weight of 1 lakh tablets. So, into 20 mg. Total how many zeros? 2, 3, 5, 5, 1, 6, 2, 1s are 2. 6 zeros write down. Okay? 3 zeros, 3 zeros. So, the weight of 1 lakh tablets is 20 lakhs milligrams. 20 lakhs milligrams. 20 lakhs milligrams. We know 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. Therefore, 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. 1 gram equal to 1000 milligrams. When we convert this milligrams into grams, we have to divide 1000 because 1 gram equal to 1000 milligrams, no? That's why. This 3 zeros cancel. 2000 grams. 2000 grams. 2000 grams, no? 1 kg equal to how many grams? 1000 grams. This 2000 grams convert into kgs. Okay? So, 2000 divided by 1 kg equal 1000 grams, no? So, 1000 kgs. Because grams convert into kgs, that's why. This 3 zeros cancel. 2 kgs. Remember, Nana, 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. Okay, once again I will explain. A box contains 1 lakh tablets, each weighing that is the weight of all tablets in the box in both grams and kilograms. The weight of one tablet 20 milligrams. The weight of 1 lakh tablets, how can we find? When we multiply 20 into 1 lakh, we have to get 20 lakhs milligrams. So, they are asking in the box, convert into grams, kilograms. Okay, 20 lakhs milligrams. This is convert into grams. When we convert milligrams into grams, divided by 1000. Okay, 20 lakhs divided by 1000. 3 zeros cancel. 2000 grams remaining is there. Again, this grams convert into kilograms. Okay, 2000 grams divided by 1000 is equal to 2 kgs.
Fourth one, a petrol tanker contains 20,000 liters of petrol. Express the quantity of a petrol in kiloliters and milliliters. A petrol tanker contains how many liters? 20,000 liters of petrol. Express the quantity of petrol, kiloliters and milliliters. The quantity of petrol in a petrol tanker, 20,000 liters. Petrol tanker quantity how much? 20,000 liters. First, convert this 20,000 liters into kiloliters. Kiloliters and milliliters, no? So, when we convert kiloliters, 1,000 liters equal to 1 kiloliter. So, liters convert into kiloliters, we have to divide with 1,000. 20,000 divided by 1,000. Kiloliters, again you have to change measurement to. So, here 3 zeros cancel. So, 20 kiloliters. This one convert into milliliters. Kiloliters, next milliliters. 20 kiloliters. We know already 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliters. 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliters. So 20,000 liters convert into milliliters. 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliters. So 20,000 liters, when we convert milliliters, we have to multiply it with 1000. That's it. 1 liter equal to 1000 ml, no? Which is the place of liter, we have to multiply it with 1000. 20,000 into 1000 ml. Okay, 20,000 into 1000 ml. So here 4 zeros, 3 zeros, total how many zeros? 7 zeros. So 2 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Here 2 ones are 2, 4 zeros and 3 zeros, total 7 zeros. So again you have to write ml, Nana. When we convert milliliters, no, liters convert into milliliters. Measurement compulsory. So this number read as ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crore. 2 crores milliliters. First they are asking convert into kiloliters. So 20,000 kiloliters, when we convert kiloliters, we have to divide 1000. Answer is 20 kiloliters. Again, they are asking convert into milliliters. Okay, so 20,000 into 1000 ml, 2 crores milliliters. This like you have to write your classwork, Nana.